Now, this is disturbing. A Team 4 investigation exposes people breaking into homes, copying computer files, and then covering their tracks on the way out.
Yeah, hard to imagine this could happen, but it does. We're not talking about criminals here. We're talking about federal law enforcement agents using a special kind of search warrant known as sneak and peek.
Here's Team 4 investigator Jim Parsons.
Andrew and Wendy, when law enforcement wants to search your home, they have to get a warrant from a judge, and then you find out about it when they show up at your door and hand you the warrant. It doesn't work like that with sneak and peek warrants. You're kept in the dark, and it's happening more and more often. They can break into your home and go through your things without you finding out for months, even a year, and it's all perfectly legal.
This tool is extremely useful to law enforcement.
And the question isn't whether they should be using them. They're using the tools we gave them. I think the question is, should we have given them these tools in the first place?
Congress made the tools easier to use in the days after the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001, incorporating delayed notice warrants, or sneak and peeks as they're known, into the Patriot Act. Before then, and even for several years after, law enforcement rarely requested them. In the Western District of Pennsylvania, federal records show zero sneak and peek warrants were obtained between 2001 and 2003. Even as late as 2007, the number was still zero. Then the following year, the U.S. Attorney's Office requested three. And in 2009, the number of applications jumped to 18. 2010 numbers haven't been filed yet. Mary Beth Buchanan was the U.S. Attorney in Pittsburgh who decided to start using sneak and peeks. She followed a national trend. 690 sneak and peek warrants in 2007, up to almost 1,300 in 2008, and up again to 1,900 in 2009.
Do you know of any cases of any of those 18, Mary Beth, where you used a delayed notice search warrant to get into someone's home and no charges were ever filed against that person?
I can't comment on that.
She also won't comment on whether any of the warrants have been used here in terrorism cases. But the numbers of those cases are low. In 2009, sneak and peek warrants were obtained in only 14 terrorism cases nationwide out of 1,900 total sneak and peeks. That's less than 1%. 77% of them went to drug cases, followed by 4% for fraud and 3% for extortion.
I think the Patriot Act was sold to the American people as a necessary tool to combat terrorism. The sneak and peek provisions are not used to fight terrorism. They're used to fight this war on drugs.
Well, for those people who think and who continue to say that the Patriot Act was only intended to address terrorism, those critics are simply wrong.
Sneak and peek warrants can cause trauma for targets who turn out to be innocent.
This has caused a lot of trauma to myself and my family.
Portland, Oregon attorney Brandon Mayfield was taken into custody as a material witness in the Madrid train bombings of 2004. But the federal government later admitted a fingerprint found at the scene that they thought was Mayfield's was in fact not.
We were actually seeing telltale signs that somebody had been in our house, that had burglarized our home. And that created a great deal of paranoia, fear, and suspicion even before I was actually arrested.
Now, it really is something that should concern everybody because it is an extreme invasion of privacy, and it's done in a way where you cannot limit the damage by the prosecutors or the law enforcement officials.
It is essential to the investigation or the safety of witnesses or the safety of the evidence that they go in and delay notice. So that's all that the law does. It delays giving the property owner notice.
Could be you. It could be anybody.
Stephen Stallings was one of Mary Beth Buchanan's top prosecutors. He's now in private practice.
When agents execute a search warrant, Jim, you know what they took. It's gone, and they leave you an inventory. But when agents execute a sneak and peek, you have no way of knowing what they've looked at. There's no check on that. You know, we've gone from give me liberty or give me death to take my liberties and give me a false sense of comfort. I think that's wrong.
And we asked the federal government to tell us which cases here in Western Pennsylvania had sneak and peek search warrants. That information was denied to us. We have the annual reports, though, to Congress on sneak and peek warrants for the last 3 years posted on our website, WTAE.com. Go to the Team 4 page, and you'll find numbers of warrants and types of cases for every part of the country. That's on our website right now.
Wow.
And it's easy to feel like this could never happen to me. Yeah. I'm just boring.
Right. And it can because, you know, and you can't fault the agents, like Steve Stallings said. I mean, we gave them the tools. They're going to use the tools that we give them.
Right.
Jim.
All right, Jim.